So, we press super for entering Windows picking state. And let's open two windows. And now we have the Windows icons, plus the subtle zoom effect on hover. Most importantly, when we drag a window, the scaling animation is gone and instead we have a small virtual desktop's map on top. And obviously we have all the common functionality, like moving windows etc. And we also have the app picking state, which is like that. But some things will be different on the final release, so no reason for saying more. First off, I'm a big fan of the new horizontal layouts, but there are a couple of problems. For example, Shell 40 was initially designed without these virtual desktop thumbnails. So what happens now is that we have the top bar, then we have the search, then the workspaces list that is ridiculously tiny so it can fit, then is the window overview, and finally the dash. So everything is overcomplicated, messy, and not really practical. One of the things I believe Shell 40 doesn't fix, is the default user experience. And I think we'll need for one more GNOME release to use some kind of extension. And I mostly mean the default dash together with the top panel, that they steal lots of screen space, they make Shell too bloated, and they don't really add much of functionality either. So we could use something like dash to panel extension, but because it doesn't support Shell 40 yet, we can only imagine it. Maybe we could kinda simulate it a bit. We can use this extension that fortunately already supports Shell 40, and we can hide a few things. For start I'm gonna hide the top panel, since dash to panel merges that with the dash on bottom. And next I'm gonna hide the search input, since we don't need that and steals precious space. So everything looks already more clean on Windows overview, but one last thing we can do is to make those workspace thumbnails bigger. I'm gonna edit the size directly to shell source code and rebuild it, but it only takes like 10 minutes to create a shell extension and override such functions. And even if you don't know how to do it, you have nothing to worry about, because someone else will do it for you. Anyway, so under the UI JavaScript code, we just need to open the workspace thumbnails file, and there is a max thumbnail scale variable that is set to 5% of the screen size, and I'm going to double this to 10. And because we have some more free space to use on top, since we removed shell panel and search input, the actual overview size will remain around the same. Okay, build done, and replace shell. So here we are. It is not super better, but it is better. And meanwhile, I still don't understand why we can move windows from the workspaces thumbnails, and not actually move and rearrange the workspaces themselves. That is way more useful.